Welcome to a new video from EU Droneport. After using the SORA 2.0 methodology for a while, the European Aviation Safety Agency is working on an update called SORA 2.5. This new version will include a way to measure ground risk more precisely and will also make the text simpler and easier to understand. If you want to know more about the 2.0 methodology, you can check out our other article. When you've completed the SORA process, you will need to create three important sets of documents. Operations Manual. This manual will contain procedures that your team needs to follow to ensure safe drone operations. It's based on the safety objectives and mitigations you've implemented. Evidence of Compliance. You'll need to provide evidence that you've met all the safety requirements and levels of assurance. The specifics of what you need to show will depend on the level of assurance required. SORA Safety Case. This document describes how you've gone through the SORA process and outlines each step you've taken. The first step in this process is to gather all the necessary information to complete these documents once you've finished all the SORA steps. There have been made some important changes in one of the steps, including a new table to assess risk on the ground. You can find the complete table in the article. When we look at population density, we'll use maps that consider how it changes throughout the year and day. For example, during the day, areas with lots of businesses may have more people, while residential areas might have fewer people at night. Additionally, in this step, we also determine how big the nearby area is and what level of risk it presents. Also, some updates have been made to the measures that help reduce the ground risk class value, as outlined in the previous section. In this case, Step 4 remains unchanged, but some changes are made regarding clarifications to help you better understand certain terms, like what is meant by atypical airspace and how we determine the size of adjacent airspace. The goal is to make the process more user-friendly and accessible. In the new SORA 2.5, this step has been moved to Step 9. They have also restructured the list of operational security objectives. But don't worry, the content remains the same. In the new SORA 2.5, you'll find this step as Step 8. Now, let's talk about Step 2. Significant improvements are made here. This step guides you on how to calculate the size of the adjacent airspace and assess the risk associated with it. We use population density as a key factor in this calculation to ensure your operations are safe. Lastly, it's worth emphasizing that at this step, you should have gathered all the necessary evidence of compliance and completed the required documentation. If you ever require assistance with managing risk assessments to enable your drone flights in new and challenging scenarios, please don't hesitate to visit our flight authorizations page on our website. We are here to support you in safely expanding your drone operations. For more information regarding SORA 2.5 methodology, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights.